2552. The Human Covenant War has been going on for over 2 decades, so damn it, sometimes a soldier needs a vacation. Before I left the Reach to cash in my vacation days, Dr. Halsey hacked into the Covenant Battle.net and found this beautiful ring world called Halo. With a name like Halo, I was instantly intrigued, and I hopped right on the opportunity to go on a space cruise and visit this luxurious getaway. After all, angels have halos, so I figured this place had to be filled with all the goodness in the world. The brochure itself left me breathless. Foreign structures, beautiful beaches, and even a winter wonderland. But somehow they knew. Those goddamn buggers. They found out, and now they're pissed off. The only people who knew we were coming here was Dr. Halsey and the Pillar of Autumn's crew. I'm not sure how much I can trust my teammates, so it looks like my vacation is gonna have to wait a few more days. When I talk to Captain Keyes, he hands me a pistol. Not only that, but apparently it's not loaded.
I don't keep it loaded, son. You'll have to find ammo as you go.
Captain, you know I only use the MA5B. That's why they call me MA5B man. Already I'm being sabotaged. This is exactly why I'm a pessimistic, glasses half full kind of guy. Your incompetence has been noted, Captain Keyes. The captain is gonna crash land on the ring, so I take Cortana and try to leave ASAP before this psycho gets us all killed. I guess he's gonna take his vacation or die trying. As I try to leave the bridge, problem number 2 presents itself in big bold letters. These grunts got to the bridge scarily fast, and without harm. They have to go through me first, but I'm unable to kill them at this point because in order to pick up the assault rifle, the doors have to open. And they only open when the grunts die, so I thought the challenge was an immediate fail. I ran back to the bridge to cower in fear and wait for my inevitable death. And that's when I noticed the checkpoint. It is quite curious that these Ungoy had the chance to storm the bridge and kill the captain, but chose not to. Very curious. But the doors opened, so now I could begin my genocidal campaign in peace and get closer to securing my vacation. The Pillar of Autumn is a simple level to get through. The only enemies are grunts and elites, and although the elites have those powerful energy shields, the MA5B cuts through their defenses really fast in a close quarters fight, like a hot knife through butter. The ammo for my rifle is scattered all around the ship, so running out is never an issue. By far, the toughest fight in this level are the bent doors, because I need to smack them in order to progress through the level. I tried to kill them with my rifle, but they wouldn't budge. I figured the challenge was doomed here, but I let it slide because inanimate objects don't count as enemies. I continued through the ship, killing enemies and resupplying my teammates with fresh ammunition, until we hopped on the life pod and descended towards Halo before Keyes could kill us all with his suicidal intentions. We crash land on the ring and everyone dies. Oh, lucky me! I have power armor, pussies! Get fucked! I didn't have the time to grieve because Halo was a paradise, a place to be happy, so I left their corpses in God's hands. The assault rifle is more like an SMG in terms of performance. It has a large magazine with 60 rounds, a high rate of fire, and it quickly loses accuracy and damage with range. So open maps like Halo poses a real problem. With the lack of cover, the Covenant quickly shred my shields. Playing cocky and carelessly works well in the first level, but down here, you can only do that if you've drank up all of your polyjuice potion like a good little Spartan, blend into their ranks to get up close, and then drop a surprise ambush. But this isn't Harry Potter, so down here, the only option left is Operation Kisoabud. Kill every inhuman son of a bitch without dying. The purple elites are strong and deal out a lot of damage. Trying to kill them in the open, especially in groups of other Covenant, is a dangerous dice roll. This is also where we're introduced to Jackals. They're actually easier to kill in open areas because you have time to dodge their overcharged shots and you can easily swing around them to hit them where it hurts. I think with this level I just got lucky with how quickly the Jackals were dying, but if I've learned anything in this life, it's that luck tends to run out. We get our first ever Warthog, and I drive very carefully, as hitting any enemy will result in their death and the failure of the challenge. I pretty much just use it for getting to places faster, use it as a ladder, or use it as a distraction. I go around to section A, B, and C, trying to save my men since a vacation alone would get pretty lonely. Section A and B were really easy. There was plenty of cover, and they came to me for the most part, but section C was a little more tricky. There is cover over by my friends, but I was impatient and used the Warthog as mobile cover, which almost backfired, but eventually they all died. Echo 419 picks us up and drops us off near a ship called the Truth and Reconciliation so we can get in and free the captain. Hell yeah! Operation Save the Suicidal Homie. My excitement quickly turned into disgust as I witnessed that I was holding a sniper rifle in my hands. Ugh. Don't get me wrong, sniper rifles are great weapons. They provide for a great in-depth view of Cooch and make you look like the most alpha man in the bar. But MA5B Man only uses the MA5B. Everything about this level screams stealth. It's nighttime, the grunts are sleeping, the sniper rifle is suppressed, and Harry even left his invisibility cloak here for us to use. But stealth is for Dewey Pooey Nimrods, so once again, I go in guns a-blazing. Keeping my men alive was very important because there are plenty of enemies I need to kill. There is some ammo laying around on the ground, but without my men's kill assist, I would quickly burn through it all. Also, my marines drop ammo when killed, so they would be a readily available ammo cache. The marines and I killed every alien until we reached the gravity lift. Right here, wave after wave of Covenant come down the lift trying to stop us from entering the ship. Even though the smart thing to do was to get all the forces to stay in the ship and ambush us all when we came up, staying alive just isn't as thrilling as getting yourself killed, right, Captain Keys? We get introduced to the Hunters at this point. Their appearance and brute strength would make any sane man rethink his recent life decisions up until this point. But fortunately, Master Chief does his goddamn homework and knows that you can sidestep and finish them off quickly with several hundred accurately placed shots. Inside the Covenant ship, there are seemingly hundreds of enemies to kill, wave after wave after wave after wave. Similarly to the Pillar of Autumn, there's a lot of close range encounters. The longer ranged battles were surprisingly easy since my men help out, and before we knew it, we were in the brig. The first brig we went into was holding nothing but dead bodies and supplies. I burst into Keyes' brig and gunned down everything with a heartbeat. Not even the Sword Elite could catch me with my epic, cat-like agility. I free Captain Keys, and some disturbing new evidence has been uncovered. Halo isn't a paradise, but a weapon of mass destruction. My comrades and I felt deceived. Wait a minute, Keys. When did you learn to speak Shangheili? Very curious. Very curious indeed. The prison cells have some more ammo in them, so I stock up and backtrack through the ship so the boys and I can kill more Covey and get one step closer to our vacation. Halo may be a weapon, but it's still a beautiful getaway. We kill some aliens, make it to the hangar, and Captain Keyes can pilot the ship? Very curious again. He's just full of surprises. Mission 4 is short and simple, kind of. We get a first-hand look at how beautiful this place is, but we also have a mission to complete, and MA5B Man will see it done. We storm the beach, kill some aliens, and I restock on ammo so I'm not defenseless. I decorate the ground with Covenant corpses, and then make my way into the facility to kill some big ol' hunters, and press a button that will unlock this door. Getting past the Covenant-filled structure was simpler than it looked, but after I hopped down to the lower level, I had no idea how much harder it would be leaving this place than it was getting into it. On the way out, there was a fuck ton of elites, jackals, grunts, and hunters, so there was no way I could slaughter them all. Slipping past them wasn't too hard. Taking the long way around proved to be helpful, but there was a sword elite guarding the exit, and he was unpredictable. He would move around, acting all retarded, but when he lost focus, he would close in for the kill. I tried being defensive, and that didn't work, so I became offensive, and he didn't know how to adapt to this change in strategy, so he fucking died. I killed the invisible boys, hopped in the Pelican, and flew underground. So far, this is the level with the least amount of ammo for the MA5B. With the amount of enemies, vehicles, and long-range encounters, I decided that stealth would be my best weapon. In the majority of the rooms, it was easier to slip by the Covenant, because the one time I did try engaging in a firefight, it used up most of my ammo and I just barely got by. The worst parts was when a doorway was guarded by a Sword Elite, but I was able to outrun them, outgun them, or they would decide a 200-foot fall is the best way to survive a grenade blast. I had to be super careful not to hit anything in the vehicle sections, and I was lucky enough to grab a Banshee before this Elite could. I cleared out all the Covenant from this room with my rifle, since I felt flying over them was too risky because I might accidentally roadkill one of them. I talked to Cortana, and my next mission is to stop Keyes from getting his hands on the Covenant weapons cache. We get dropped off in a swamp, and I can only hope that the Onion Lord reveals himself to me. Luckily, from here until the end of the game, the Jackals aren't too much of an issue. Don't get me wrong, there are still times where they're the biggest bullet wasters in the history of this game, but they won't be thorns embedded in my colon anymore. Instead, they'll just be more like an itchy butthole. This level is, of course, where the Flood is introduced to us. There's plenty of MA5B rounds scattered throughout the level, so ammo conservation is not an issue. As usual, the best strategy was stealth, but weighing over a ton makes sneaking around a little tricky. So I snatched up the invisibility power and left my men's lives in Fate's hands. No doubt about it that I could have saved them, but they would be more of a liability than anything. I didn't get too lost in this level, which is quite surprising, and then I rendezvoused with my men as quickly as I arrived here. They saw me as a beacon of hope in these dire times. Oh, my friend, you seem to be under the impression that I'm gonna save you all. Since I'm simply MA5B man, I need to use a strategy that's commonly known as every man for himself. Getting through the swamp was tricky because running from the Flood was a death wish, and so was fighting them, so my best chance was to run and gun until the Sentinels grabbed their attention. 343 Guilty Spark says howdy, and he teleports us to the library. People hate on the library because
it's repetitive.
But think of how a normal library looks. It's row after row, shelf after shelf, of nothing but books. So of course, both libraries are gonna be repetitive, you close-minded swine. I quickly found that running from the Flood got me killed really fast. Their numbers are far greater in this level, so they could hit shot after shot, giving me no time to recharge my shields. The two hardest sections in this level are the beginning before the first door opens, and the last firefight before I get the index. Everything else in between is simple because there's plenty of ways to avoid fights, either by being quick and sneaky or getting an easy despawn. Standing right here will make sure that the only enemies who spawn are the carriers, so that's a major fight avoided. Any other time when I had to wait for a door to open and I had to defend against the Flood, I would just stand in the indent in one of these walls or hide in the corner. Apparently, violence isn't always the answer. And in these hallways, I just went around the lip of the cliff to avoid getting blown up. The rocket Flood is scary, but I only ever died once to their explosive surprises. The first section of the mission doesn't leave you with a lot of ammunition, and there's a decent chunk of Flood that you need to kill, or else they'll 100% give me a nice serving of death for Christmas. Killing the Flood wasn't too hard, considering that they drop assault rifles frequently, and the Fatty Boom Batty forms kill most of the Cucklord forms for me. You already know what happens when I get through this door. I ride a couple of elevators, run and gun, and avoid most of the fights. Rinse and repeat. The end of the level is problematic because there's a fuckton of simps waiting to gun me down. At first I thought getting through would be impossibly difficult, but luring the Flood down the hallway while shooting them and using evasive maneuvers worked a lot better than I initially thought it would. So everyone died, I ran to the elevator, grabbed the index, and then Guilty Spark teleports me to the control room. So far, this was the hardest level of the entire run. I died so many times to straight up bullshit. The rocket flood was like Anne Frank, but instead of hiding in the attic, the rocket flood was hiding around the corner and would always wait to pop out until it was close enough to shove the barrel of the rocket launcher up my urethra, and then it would blow us both to smithereens. You begin the mission with a plasma pistol and a shotgun. I couldn't kill the sentinels, and everyone knows how lethal lasers are, so I had to circle around the room and then tried to get past everything without dying. They almost got the chance to slide their alien peens into my vulnerable Spartan butthole, but I was able to hide behind the energy shield. Getting to the Banshee was hard since they had a battalion of boys guarding it, but using my big brain and with a bit of luck, I outmaneuvered them all and slid into Dat Banshee. I had to run by every group of enemies I came into contact with until I got my hands on a MA5B. And the entire time I was trying to grab it, I was being gangbanged by Flood, Elites, and Jackals trying to kill me through Forerunner glory holes. The bridges in this level are always packed with Flood or Covenant, but since they're all focused on each other, I got past without dying. But that doesn't mean I didn't gain a battle scar or two in the process. Getting through the next room took me 15 minutes. The room is packed with about 20 Flood, but that's not the problem. I never died fighting these guys or even the guys in the hallway, but it was because that rocket Flood form was a bitch-ass dimmy doodle. I was only able to get past him because when I was playing the dangerous form of Ring Around the Rosie, he ended up killing himself because he got tired of chasing me. Patience is a virtue, my friend. The good thing about dealing with the Flood is that I always pretty much had full ammo since I like to carry weapons around. I got outside, grabbed the ghost, and avoided everything from here until I reached the Banshees. I flew up to this platform, killed these suckas, and this next part is damn annoying to deal with. At first I tried running and gunning past the Flood, but they would always sandwich me and spread my cheeks like butter on toast. The best way of getting past was to kill everything, which was a matter of trial and error because once again there's Rocket Flood. Stupid fucking Rocket Flood. When I eventually got past them all, I took the Banshee and flew underground. This section was easy, nothing worth mentioning. Once I got outside, I realized it was a piece of shit MA5B man nightmare, because it was a long range fight, there was a Banshee, tons of enemies, just a real nasty section. After continuous anger inducing deaths, I decided that it was best to kill the Banshee, stick to the right side of the fight, grab a ghost, and drive to where the Banshees were parked. Breaking through enemy lines was way too easy, so I took the Banshee, flew to the objective, disabled the generator, and Cortana teleports me to the Truth and Reconciliation. Getting to the gravity lift was the easiest part of the level, despite being surrounded by Covenant and Flood. I ran by everyone while they were fighting each other, and then I ascended to a better place. Even though the inside of the ship is harder, I do love it because it's close quarters, the ideal location to use the MA5B. Everyone in the ship was clumped together, so I used the bullet hose to kill or weaken the troops, and then they generously helped me by finishing the job. Even though the rifle isn't great at quickly killing Flood, it does disarm and stun them, giving you breathing room to reload your weapon and finish the job. I squeezed my way through the Death Hallway of Death and finally found Keys in his true form. I knew he was an alien this whole time. It all makes perfect sense. The Covenant knowing where we were, him knowing how to speak Shangheili, his piloting skills, the fact that he was taken prisoner and wasn't killed like the rest of his men were, and trying to sabotage me from the very beginning. It was clear that he was an alien and had gotten his hands on Polyjuice Potion. He was pretending to be a human this whole time, but at last, his secret was revealed. I fucking annihilate him for being a double agent traitor, I kill some more Flood, I do some epic parkour to get down to the Banshees, I take one and leave the Flood-infested ship. The Master Chief bamboozles Cortana by making her think he's gonna kill himself, but instead he pulls an epic prank. You really think that's how I would kill myself? Dumbass motherfucker. Another mission with close quarters combat. It's like the gaming gods are watching out for me. I don't start off with a lot of ammo, and after I cleared out this hallway, my ammo counter gave me a proper scare. But as usual, there's a fuck ton of ammo in this level. I quickly kill everything from here until the bridge. Turns out Guilty Spark has entered the crib without our permission, and he doesn't want us to blow up the ship because he's fascinated with human history. Naturally, I really hate it when people tell me what to do, so now I have no choice but to blow up the ship, along with everyone on board. I rip and tear through all the flood, and once I hit the hallway of infinite flood spawns, I get through it ASAP so I can get that sweet overshield body condom, and needlessly kill these sexy ass Spec Op Covenant forces, because damn it, I just love to kill shit. The engine room introduces a new problem because I have to destroy the engines using explosives, and unfortunately, I left my explosive ammunition in my other pants, so I was forced to use grenades to take out the four engines. You can call this a fail if you want, but I don't consider it a complete fail because just like the door in the first mission, it's not like I'm using the grenades to kill enemies. Once I blow up the engines, I make my way to the elevator and I drain the life essence from the Covenant Nimrods who invade my realm and try to stop me on the elevator. I ride it up and hop in the Warthog. Up until this point, I never killed anyone with anything other than my MA5B, so that's exactly what I intended to do in the Warthog run. 6 minutes is more than enough time to safely make it to Papa John's longsword, so I kill all the enemies here and then continue driving. I still remembered my strategy for my pistol only challenge, so here's a quick summary of the Warthog run. In these open sections, I easily dodged every flood form and Covenant soldier. Right here I slowed down just a little bit so I could slip by them while they were distracted. I let Echo 419 die alone here because she was a flying dead man and I wanted to get away with as much time to spare as possible. I allowed some pedestrians to cross the road safely, I dived headfirst into the pit and got launched from the vehicle, and from here until the longsword I moved on foot. An infection form or two may have died from the Warthog, but we can let it slide. Get it? Slide? I wasn't in the vehicle, so fuck you, it doesn't count. I say farewell to the last elite I will see in the challenge, and I get the fuck out of there. Halo blows up, and now I was quite salty that all these soldiers had died, and we never even got the chance to take our vacation and go swimming in the beautiful ocean. However, I was able to beat Halo with only the MA5B. That is, if we aren't counting the doors in the beginning and the reactors at the end of the game. Thanks for watching, and Happy New Year. Farewell, 2020.